Hello, everybody. I'm a new addition to TGN FPS here, and I'm playing some Battlefield 3. I know it's a huge game that came out, and for about a week I didn't play it because there were so many issues with the servers and the gameplay itself. But Battlefield 3 is slow. I mean, sorry, DICE is slowly addressing the problems in Battlefield 3, so I'm happy about that. Right now I'm playing with the RPK 74M, I think it's called. I'm not too good with gun names as of yet because I haven't played it enough to know them off by heart. But yeah, I've been playing with the LMG class because I like to throw ammo down and help resupply my team. It's a great way to give them some support. I do play with the AK-74U sometimes, and I have done a little bit of sniping, but not that much because sniping seems a little bit harder because it's not one-hit kill in the chest region, and my aim isn't good enough at the moment. So I might try it later on, but until then, I'm trying to stay away from it because, well, let's face it, sniper gameplay isn't really entertaining to watch unless it's like in a montage or something and you got like the quick scopes and the no scopes and the cross map headshots. Anyway, I'm actually really happy to be a part of the TGN FPS group here. TGN seems to be a really great network to be working with, channel. I guess I should just say it's a network. It does have a website. If you guys want to be a part of TGN, make sure to go to the links down below in the description and just watch some of the videos they have in those links, and you will love what TGN is doing. I'm thinking it'll take over for Machinima because TGN has so much room to grow, and growing with them is something I want to do. I would rather grow with a channel and help grow with them instead of having a channel like Machinima and just being paid to put up videos when they can't grow that much more. So I know that's really weird of me to say, but that's just what's in my mind right now. I haven't really prepared anything really special to say. I'm just going to tell you that I'm playing on Operation Metro. The best thing to do is, since this is a rush game and they are attacking, just kind of hold the middle ground. Don't really go too far into it because then there'll be a lot of people spawning and you'll be outnumbered pretty quickly. So you want to take the middle area so you still got both bases, or is it bases? Yeah, I'll just call them bases, A and B area, in sight so that you can actually just turn around and go and clear it out and then go and save it and whatnot. If I go too far, it's usually because there's not enough people pushing up and they're starting to snipe, so I want to go around and take some of them out, like so they don't flank us, which is a really good thing to do, because you don't want to get flanked in this game, because if they get into your spawn, they can do a lot of damage. That's about it, really. I mean, anyone who's ever played Battlefield 3 beta knows exactly what's going on in Operation Metro, but I do have a decent gameplay here, 16-4, not too bad. And it's just because I'm defending that I'm kind of campy. If I'm attacking, I usually go for the objectives. Sorry, I have a little bit of indigestion going on. But yeah, I'm usually quite, how can I say it? I rush a lot, which is, I guess, why it's called rush. But anyway, so I don't really have any tips for you. If I did, I would let you know. All I can really say is work on your aim. Aim is key in this game, and make sure you communicate with your team. This game is so team-based, it's unbelievable. I remember playing a couple of games with definite COD players because they were saying, oh my god, this game is so different compared to COD. But anyway, they would always rush in, and they were on my team, and they just didn't go for the objective, and they weren't very helpful, so the other team had an advantage of winning the game. And I do prefer winning over kill-death ratio, so it was kind of painful to watch, and I hope it doesn't happen to me anymore. It's just painful. But yeah, so Halloween passed the last couple days, and I didn't really do anything, because after moving, I kind of don't have any friends where I am. And I mean, Halloween is usually the time where you go party and get drunk. But I wasn't able to do that, sadly, so I just recorded video games. So this is what I recorded on Halloween. I know it's so, I guess you could say, pathetic, but you know what? It's just what I do, okay? It's all I can say. But anyways, if you guys are really excited for Modern Warfare 3 and you guys are watching this right now, you guys might want to watch the live stream that'll be happening on Twitch TV, on the night it comes out, or is it going to be during the day? I don't know. On the day it comes out, there is going to be a Modern Warfare 3 stream. So I believe I'm going to be putting the link in the description. Just look for something that says Twitch TV, And that'll take you to, I think, the site. I'm not sure if it'll take you directly to the person's live stream, but it'll take you to the site. I'll talk to my channel manager and see if he's got a direct link. But, yeah, so I know Modern Warfare 3 is coming out. You guys must be pumped as... Well, I can't... I'm not going to swear. I know you guys must be pumped. Another game that's coming out that I'm really, 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 really psyched for is Skyrim. Oh, man, all the hours that was put into Oblivion is amazing. So if Skyrim's anything like Oblivion, I'm going to be playing that game for at least 300 hours. And that is, like... it's like a requirement. You have to play it that much to really enjoy it. I've also been told that like a number of other games are coming out, like Need for Speed, Assassin's Creed, Uncharted 3, War in the North, Modern Warfare 3. Holy hell, this is going to be a powerful month. And I just know on my channel I won't be able to keep up with all the games. But I am also a part of TGN Let's Play, and I'm doing a Dead Rising 2 off the record Let's Play, and I'm also doing, I will be doing a Gears of War 3 on Insane Let's Play. So hopefully that'll get some views, maybe, I don't know. I'm just hoping people will watch it and like it. If not, then you know what, I have something I need to work on, right? Anyways. One thing I've noticed about Battlefield 3 videos is they're a lot longer than Call of Duty videos, and it's much more tedious than Call of Duty, because you can run into a room in Call of Duty and take out 7 guys at once with, like, an SMG, and in this game, it's much, much harder. I remember going into a room with, like, 2 people, and I'll, like, kill one, the other one will revive the other one, and he'll just start shooting me, and then my god, it was just brutal. That being said, Battlefield 3 is a game where time just seems to melt away. Like, you'll be playing this game for 3 hours, and it'll seem like it's only been played for half an hour. But that said, it's not usually a really good game for YouTube videos, but I don't know. It depends on how long your audience is willing to listen to you talk and babble on. See, me, I'm talking for about, what, 12 minutes, 13 minutes, 15 minutes? I have no idea. But in Call of Duty... Like, if you're really good at the game, you can end the game in, like, 3 minutes. I don't think you could do that in this game, unless you play TDM, but I haven't played TDM yet, because, why did I say TDM? I'll just say Team Deathmatch. I haven't played the Deathmatch yet, because I'm really into the objective gameplay of Battlefield 3. I think that's the reason I would play it over Call of Duty, and the reason I would play Call of Duty over this is because if I really wanted a fast-paced gameplay where I can end a game... really quickly and just have fun with my friends and, like, dick around and all that shit. Oh, I swore. Oops. Okay, sorry. Then, yeah, I'll play Call of Duty. But until then, if I want to play something with strategy needed and teamwork is involved, I would play this because this has both of that. And I also really do like the community, too. There's not a lot of really big squeakers on there. Like, people don't really yell and shriek and shit like that. There are some issues with servers still where there's lag and some things to do with gun damage, but it's not too bad. I mean, it's still really fun, and it's still probably more balanced than Black Ops ever was. Because let's face it, when does Call of Duty ever take care of their games? I mean, if they did, but there wouldn't be modders in Modern Warfare 2 right now. But anyways, enough... I don't want to start a flame floor. I don't want to start a flame war because that's just pointless. Nobody's ever going to win a flame war because there's two sides to every story and they're two completely different games. If you're comparing two Call of Duty games like Call of Duty 4 and Modern Warfare 2, then yeah, go ahead, debate it all you want. If you're comparing Bad Company 2 and Battlefield 3, go ahead, debate. I mean, if it's the same series and it's a game where there's different changes, yeah, go ahead. But, like, if you're comparing Call of Duty and Halo, I mean, what the hell's wrong with you? I mean, that's just the stupidest thing I've ever heard. One is set 500 years in the future, the other one is set for now, the other one has regenerating health and super suits, power armor, and the other one doesn't. Yeah, I mean, I've heard some crazy flame wars, and I don't know why I'm talking about this. I think I've gotten way off topic. But anyways, as you can see, I've just been holding the middle line across there, and I like to go down by the river and see if anyone's trying to flank or swim to that island. because sniper, a lot of snipers like to go to that island because it's a good vantage point for B. They can just pick off people, and I hate that so much that they put that in there. So I always like to go down by the river, see if anyone's just trying to swim across, and if there's nobody there, I'd like to go to the path right beside it and see if anyone's crossing the bridge or just about to come down and flank. And that's just my strategy. It happened to get me a pretty good KD ratio, and we ended up winning the game, so... And that's all that's really meant to be said about the gameplay. I do get one death that really pissed me off, and that was the standing next to the burnt satellite or whatever. I have no idea what it was. It was just like some burning wreckage, and it just killed me. And I was like, oh, okay, so I can die by fire. So there's one death that I wish I didn't get, but oh well. What can you do? You can't complain about everything. So I still ended up doing pretty well. My team worked really well. They just killed everyone. But then again, the other team wasn't really that good, so I don't really know how much I can really take credit for. But anyways, guys, this is my first video. If you would like some more from me, please like and favorite it. And I'm really glad to be a part of TGN FPS. Make sure to check out the live stream for Modern Warfare 3. Look at all the links down below, because We Are YouTube is probably one of the best movements I've seen on YouTube. So definitely take a look. If you guys want to leave comments for me, go ahead. I will reply to them with my own channel, Red Rings TV. If you guys want to come to my channel and see other gameplays, make sure to click the link down below. Anyways, guys, I will talk to you later. Have a great night, everyone, and I'm glad I was talking.